Hey guys, welcome to Professional Farmer 2014 with me, Brad. I'm 73. We're gonna get started. I just did boot into the game, so aside from like an oversensitive mouse, it looks like I'm gonna have to create a new gamer profile. So it's just gonna be, I guess it's just all uppercase. So it's just gonna be Brad. I'm 73. Okay, choose what. Okay, it's about 3:24 in the morning right now, and just got done installing it off of Steam. It just did go live. Mouse sensitivity, yeah, that's much better. Okay, controls, sound option, supposedly the music is very loud, so we'll turn the down just a little bit. And from what I understand, there's basically two play modes. There's career mode and then there's free play mode. And free play mode is kind of like Farming Simulator 2013, which is made by a completely different company, where you just kind of start off in the game. I don't think you have too much, and you just kind of build your way up however you want. Career mode supposedly is a little, not necessarily story driven, but you're given objectives that you have to complete, supposedly. This is just by going off of information that I've already read. So we're going to get, I have not even played this game at all yet. This is kind of the new version of UIG's AgroR Simulator. But AgroSim was developed, at least the 2013 version. I'm not sure if 2011 was or not, but 2013 was developed by Actalogic, and the gaming engine was buggy and less than stellar. And thankfully, I did not have the horror of playing that game. Just watching others play it was terrible enough. But UIG's gone with a new developer called Playway, and the gaming engine is called Argon 6. And supposedly it's a much better gaming engine than the old engine. So yeah, so we're gonna jump in. We're gonna just start off a career mode here. And whoops, what did I just do? Okay, there we go. So we're loading into the game. Look, the tractor has a little smiley face and two hands. It's like, come and feed me. All right, and whoa, frame rate's there we go. I was like, whoa, frame rate's really bad. Okay, so we're getting about 24, 25 frames a second right now, and doesn't look like I can zoom the camera view in. Looks like we can just walk around with the ASW keys, or ASWD keys. Or WASD, whatever you prefer. Can't pick that up. This little cage here. Can I? Oh, I can hold down shift and run fast. That's good. Okay, we can go inside. No. Whoa. Okay. This is me jumping. All right, so I think we have to follow this over here. There's a couple tractors. There's a John Deere. Looks kind of generic from inside here in the shadow, but I don't even know if we can get in it or not. And I believe this is our first tractor that will get in career mode. And where am I supposed to go? Oh, over here. Think, let's see, three. There are three types of animals in the games: hens, ducks, and cows. So we have our hens, our chickens. Know if this is going to be more chickens or ducks. Maybe the ducks go in here. I don't know. Looks like there's kind of like the further away things get, looks like there's kind of a like a blurry depth of field kind of effect going on, which is kind of interesting. I don't know what this almost looks like a silage pit here. Maybe it is. The lighting's really good. Okay, what is this area? This is your garage, a place where you can keep your vehicles, or in this case, the different equipment. Enter tractors. Just ch kind of check out the detail. Roush axis 30.1. Krampa. Krampa? Krampa. I don't know how that's spelled. It's a tipper. Our tipper wagon there. These big bags of seeds. Looks like fertilizer, possibly. Okay, you only jump about 6 inches, so that ain't much. There's a cultivator. A bunch of highly explosive things, I'm guessing. And there's a cedar. Amazon D9 4000 Super. All right, so we'll run over here. We'll get into the tractor. Okay, just like Farming Sim 2013, uses E. See, the CVT gearbox is used the continuous transmission to transfer power. No manual gear shifting. Use the Z key. I think. Okay, so there's the Z key. And then, okay. So you actually have to actually have to push accelerate to go backwards. That's a little, that's quite a bit different. How do I switch up gear? Whoops. How do I switch my gears? Oh, right there. F gear up. Apparently there's a lot of gears. Okay. Petrol station. It is much cheaper to buy large amounts of fuel and refuel your vehicles here rather than refuel each one in the town. Press enter for home fuel storage menu. Let's see the home storage menu. Your machine, the Lindner GeoTrac 114, filled with 119.11 liters of fuel out of 120. So we've got 1,000 liters. We'll go ahead and just fill up. Guess hit escape. Okay. Oh, and I just noticed our little PDA. So we've got F1, F2. You're not in the field. F3. It's got our cash, loans taken, and stuff like that. Weather forecast is unavailable. Telling us to buy a weather station. And I think we can, yeah, I was gonna say we can even switch to the external view here. That's a big tracker. Oh, good, and we can zoom in and zoom out. You store your harvested crops here in the silos. You can buy silos for all the grains and upgrade them, increasing their capability. So that's cool. So I guess we'll be able to maybe upgrade bigger silos, or actually it looks like there, if we jump out and run back here, there's actually places for the different silos. So there's like a small silo there. So I guess eventually we can get maybe really big ones that go like way up to the top there. Because right now they're really small. Okay, so now we have to go over there. Okay. This music has got to go. Oh, here's our map. I think we're down here somewhere. And I think we own these two fields. Everything else we don't own. Don't know what those are up there, but okay. And unfortunately, I don't think there's. Is there maybe like a cruise control? I just want to look at the. See, Control R, Control 1 lift. F and V, okay, gear up and gear down. Lights. Main pad, that's your map view kind of. And the camera is C. Change drive direction, Z is forward and back. Attach, detach is Q. Okay, I guess there's no cruise control. I'm gonna turn this music down a little bit more. Whoa, that's as low as it goes. Okay. All right, back to the game. So we basically have to keep our finger on the W key. Okay, it looks like 6A is as fast as we'll go. Warehouse is the place where you store your seeds and hay. All right. The spring has come. Time to do some field work. Your fields lay nearby. Let's learn how to plow, cultivate, and sow them. All right. Whoop. You need to attach the plow. Use the Q to attach and detach machines. To detach a liftable machine, blah 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 blah. Went by too quickly, so I didn't get to read the end of that there. But I'm sure we can pause the video later and see what it says. Okay, so we need to pick up this plow. Wait. Oh, so, oh, that's kind of nice. And so instead of, wait a second, why can't I? Okay, can zoom out. So this is just like a more, even farther out zoom. Okay. Here's the inside, the cabin with all of our little buttons and stuff. Yes. Whoa. Okay, am I did I just see it attack? No. Okay, the switching of the gears is a little bit annoying. Q. Not lined up right. There we go. All right. So you can view your mission goals, target, and field info on the auto map, the M key. So, it'd be nice to have like a zoom key on this. So you move to field. Okay, so here's our objectives. So move to field, attach plow, move to warehouse, follow the lead, enter track. Okay, so all right. So this is like the ones we've already done. All right. So let's just jump in here. And see if we can see to rotate the plow. Oh. Oh, I thought it was gonna be in the center. Guess not. Physics are a little bit rough. At least coming off the bump there it was, or it seemed like it was. Alright, so this is the field that we have to plow. And so I'll just kind of line it up here. Down. Whoa. Just plop it down then. Alright, and then I probably want to gear down a little bit, so we'll try. There we go. So we're doing 6 kilometers an hour. I wonder if I can switch that to miles per hour. Kind of getting, you can kind of feel, what's kind of cool about this is you can actually feel the plow tugging the tractor to the left. This game does not seem to have the same how do I want to say it, terrain deformation that AgrarSim 2013 had, and that honestly, if any of you guys out there played the Agriculture Simulator 2013, that's probably one of the biggest reasons why that game had so many problems. I mean, they were being really optimistic on, you know, what they were trying to do with that game engine, and you know, it just really didn't work. I'm gonna go a little bit faster here. This thing is really tough to keep aligned. I mean, it doesn't go straight. You can kind of feel like, okay, you're hitting like rocks or roots or, you know, who knows whatever is underneath the soil. And let's see, how do we lift it up again? R. There we go. So it's mostly straight. Misty straight. Misty. Alright, so I'm gonna rotate the plow around to the other side. Oh. The gear shifting thing, I don't know. I don't know if I like that or not. It's kinda like, really? Do we really need to shift gears? Like I really have the desire to hit like one, two, or three to get my to you know hit my cruise control. Oh man. And it is difficult to keep your tractor aligned. Okay, now the glare on the windshield I can really do without. That's kind of a little bit overkill there. I wonder how fast we can go. Whoa. Nope, I want to drop this. Nope. I want to back up. Want to drop that. There a little bit, so we kind of like overlap the tracks, I guess, just a little bit. That way we won't have too many, you know, spots where we're out of alignment. F2, current field owner, okay. I was looking for maybe an option to, I wonder if I can go even faster. Okay, here's 14 kilometers per hour. Whoa. Yeah, the faster I go, the more of a pull that it's got. Slow us back down just a little bit. It's a little easier to control at the slower speeds. I can already tell you we need a bigger plow. But so far the game's running pretty good. Right now I'm at a solid 18 frames a second. That is with running fraps. So I would expect, you know, at least a, you know, 50% increase or more, you know, while I'm not recording. So I'll have to maybe do some farming off the screen and kind of report back to you guys on what type of frame rate I'm getting. Okay. Take a long time. I wish there was a way to, you know, if UIG's out there and they're listening to my video, which I doubt they are, but if they are, then great. It would be nice to have an option. Two things that are coming to mind so far: get rid of the Z key to switch into reversed, just do ASWD and integrate reverse into the S key. It's going to make life a lot more simple. I know, you know, or have a different control scheme that allows for a slightly more simplistic control. I think users are going to appreciate that. Let's see, what was the other thing? That and, oh, maybe have an option to switch off the music, kind of like turning your radio on and off while you're in the cab. That way you don't have to exit all the way back to the main menu and go that route. So just in case anybody out there in UIG land is listening, or what was the name of their new developer? I had it right here in front of me. It is Playway. So UIG or Playway, I guess. If anybody is listening, then integrate my suggestions. Do it now. Okay. So, whoops. No. No, I want to go the other way. Okay. Yeah, you can really feel the plow like tugging on the tractor. It kind of pulls it to the left. So I'm constantly having to correct to the right, and then when I'm coming back up the hill, I'm having to correct the opposite way, which is cool. It's gonna make Well, I don't know. We'll see how the cultivator, because first we have to plow, then we have to cultivate the field. She'll probably do the plowing in the first episode. I might even do an episode where we just run around the map really quick and kind of see what the map is like, and then we'll come back again and cultivate, and then finally plant. It's gonna take quite a long time to, to do this whole process of plowing and cultivating, and the tractors are a lot slower. The whole process seems to be, I would say, more realistic than, say, Farming Simulator 2013. That's gonna appeal to a lot of people, I think, and then I think other people might be a little bit put off by it. But I don't know. We'll see. We will see. Now, this is as high as the camera angle will go. You can't actually look straight down on the top of your tractor. You just kind of go around like that. Just kind of cool. Again, we can farm inside our tractor here. Trying to keep it lined up. Using all my concentration. So far, this game seems pretty good though. Nothing really major is jumping out at me. It's just, hello, you're playing a different game now and not Farming Sim 2013. And, just the way this one's gonna go. There's a farm across the road there. Another thing I would kind of suggest, and this isn't really a bug, but lower the amount of glare on the windshield. Like right now it's not bad, but like coming up the hill when you've got the sun on in your eyes, it's pretty distracting. I'm kind of using the front of the fender, just to the left of the steering wheel, kind of like the corner that I've got the line on right now. You can kind of see the corner of the... I'm gonna assume that it's a plastic fender. I'm just trying to line it up with kind of like that little top right corner of that fender there. And it seems to be giving me a pretty good line. Maybe I'll try this next pass and I'll speed it up. Actually, I'll speed it up now. See if we can get a little bit better speed. Around while that's turning around. Get our track lined up here. There we go. And then make sure. Alright, so we're all set. And away we go. I don't know if there's a top speed on, how fast we can go before we rip the plow off, but hopefully that won't be a major concern. Yeah, see, like right now, the glare on the windshield's a little bit distracting. like a little bit of glare would be maybe like 25% of the amount of glare that we've got right now, I think would be a good amount. Because right now it's just like somebody spilled milk all over the windshield or something. A little bit overboard, I think. No, that went pretty well. Let's try doing it at the faster speed. But you can really see it rock the tractor when it puts the... Oh, and then you can only turn, you know, like 358 degrees or something like that. You can't turn, you know, you can't just spin your head around nonstop, you know, like an internal camera view. I'm not sure if you can do that in Farming Sim, but I think you can just keep turning around and turning around in one direction nonstop, so just something to point out. Another thing that is a little bit buggy. It's more of a view perspective kind of an issue, is that the camera view seems like I'm looking through like a 35 millimeter lens or something. It's kind of the camera needs to be zoomed out about 10%, I think, just to give you. I'm gonna go with it. Zoom options. I don't know. All right, so I think we need to switch this out. Yep. Plop our plow down and let's go to town. So we're doing pretty good. Looks like we're kind of closing in on about halfway done with this field. I like the mini map, the little 3D. It's like they built like a 3D map, and made a mini map out of it. It's kind of cool. I'm gonna do something a little bit crazy. I'm gonna up the speed. I know, crazy, right? But what was that? Ugh. It's like 3:30 in the morning or so. Oh gosh, I just tipped something over on my desk. Oh, it's my bottle of water. Oops. Oh, that's what that was. Kleenex, you scared the crap out of me. I have like a Kleenex sitting on my desk just in case I go into a sneezing fit or something like that, because I've had a cold since the beginning of November and it's not going away. So that's kind of frustrating. I had my lamp off, so I'm basically sitting here in the dark, playing farming, or not farming sim, but professional farmer, and I guess my sleeve must have, on my shirt, must have pushed it off and caused it to hit the top of my foot, and I thought it was like a, you know, a Mexican barking tarantula or something like that, shooting across my foot, so yeah. Okay, so we're going 13 kph. Just gonna gear down. I can actually go faster at the lower speed, so that's interesting. Probably because it's got more torque. And it can pull it along a little bit better, so that's good. That's good to know. Yep, the end is in sight. We're a little bit more than halfway. I can't wait to see what our next task is going to be. It's probably going to be cultivating or something, I don't know. Yes, yeah, so we're getting higher torque. And if we switch up to fifth gear, yeah, we actually have less torque, so we come down in speed. We go to third gear, then we're going definitely going slower. So yeah, 4A is the gear we want to be in. It's going to give us the best speed for the torque, at least in this tractor. Other tractors may be different, or even other plows. Like if we got a bigger plow, like one that's twice as wide as this, we would probably need to, you know, test that out again to see if that's the right speed. The T button switches that over. All right, so yeah, I'm enjoying this so far. It's pretty good. Definitely a pleasant surprise, you know, after the abysmal failure that was AgrarSim 2013 from UIG, I mean, there were a lot of people that I, you know, that were our farming sim enthusiasts, and they all were like, there's no way in heck that they're buying this game. Or at least not until, you know, the reports get out of whether or not it's a total bomb or not. And I was kind of afraid too, and then I'm looking and I'm like, I see it on Steam, it's like $19.99 with 20% off, so that brings the price down to $15.99. And I did just check it, you know, when I was downloading, and so the sale is already up. So if you haven't pre-ordered, sorry guys in the US or abroad, it's going to be a little bit more expensive if you buy it from Steam. So I just decided, $16. That might be worth the risk. I mean, if it did suck and I just made a bunch of fail videos, they might be popular and might eventually pay for itself in YouTube views. But I don't know. So, I don't know. I like it. If you're liking the videos so far, don't forget to click the like button. It helps me out. Lets other people know that you're watching my videos, and helps me grow my channel. I'd really appreciate it if you hit the like button. You have my eternal thanks. Now go watch all my other videos and hit the like button. And also, you know, if you're not a subscriber yet, be sure to hit the subscribe button if you want to follow along for more Let's Play videos. I'm probably going to be like the first American to actually have a Let's Play video of this game, or at least one of the first. UIG is a German company, so and Germany, you know, is a very sim oriented, you know, there's a lot of sim oriented gamers in Germany, so you know, you see a ton of really weird simulators, like, you know, bus simulators and airport simulators and building a house simulator and just all kinds of really... I think I saw somebody do a Let's Play. It was like road construction simulator, and you actually had to go and set cones out on a road and then use a jackhammer to like repair potholes in the road. You know, I guess if the game looked absolutely, you know, this road construction game looked absolutely horrible. But, you know, who knows? There might be somebody out there that's, like, really into it, and they're, you know, maybe they might eventually base a career off of doing road construction, which is, you know, an honorable thing, I think. But, yeah, here stateside, it's basically, like, you know, Call of Duty and, you know, that kind of stuff, which, I don't know. I haven't got, my lines are pretty nice and straight now. That's pretty good. So my little technique of lining up the, can I switch my thing around? Yeah. So my technique of lining up on that little, you know, kind of angle there, you can kind of tell where I'm lining it up, you know, just to the right of the steering wheel. You can kind of see there's like a silver coin-shaped rivet that's probably holding the fender to, you know, the part of the chassis that covers the wheels. Just that little corner right there, and I'm you know, doing my best to keep it lined up, and I'm just tapping the steering wheel, just playing this with my keyboard. I don't have like an Xbox controller or steering wheel or anything like that, so I'm just, you know, gently tapping the keys as I need to make small corrections. And it looks like I'm coming out with pretty straight lines. So I think we've only got a couple more rows to go. Probably, what, maybe two, maybe three? And we'll be able to wrap this episode up, guys, for the first of hopefully many you know, professional farmer 2014 videos. I have no history with UIG games, but might as well send a thanks to UIG for fixing whatever problems were inherent in the in previous games, shall we say, and you know, putting out a product that so far seems great. Okay, new task. You can drive back home now. Well, I'm not even done with the field. I'm not going to drive back home until I'm done. Gosh. I'm definitely not going back home. Kind of getting this down a little bit. Let's see how we're doing back here. Alright. I could probably even go, let's see. If I go right along the little silver dot on the fender, let's see how I'm doing there. That's working out pretty good too. I can probably do that. That way I'll get a little bit extra, you know, not cultivating, but plowing per row. Just like driving a car, you know, when you learn to drive a car, I remember my first car was like a Ford LTD, and I took my driver's education in a similar car, and so they kind of tell you, you know, keep the double, you know, the center line, you know, on one part of the front of the car, and so they kind of train you to work off of those little cues, I guess you should say. Alright, well, let's see here. Oh, looks like we can take a shortcut. Whoa! Man! Did not see that. Well, at least our tractor can get over the stump there. Well, not, that wasn't a stump, that was a gigantic boulder. Wow. Okay. I'm kind of embarrassed that I had a fail in my first video. No crashes so far. That's good. That's a good thing. Very, 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 very good thing. Okay, so now what do we have to do to buy new field, just drive up to it and press enter. Is that what our goal is? Do that, patch a machine. Okay, detach plough. That's what I'm gonna do. And I think we have to lower it first and detach it. All right. Now it's time to cultivate the plowed fields. Let's see how we're doing on time here. Ooh. Remember to attach. You have to detach the one. Yep. That I did. Puppy up. Alright, so let's move. Whoop. Let's go back to the field. And I'm going to do a row for you guys, just so you guys can see how the cultivator works before I end the episode. Can't leave you guys hanging. Still getting like 18, 19 frames a second, which is and pretty solid actually. That means I'm probably going to be getting at least 30 or 40, you know, just doing a single player game. And I'll be sure to come back in the next episode and like kind of fill you guys in on what, you know, what my actual frames per second are, so that way you guys know. Okay, so now we have to R. Now this one we don't have to turn. Let's see here. I want to go. Let's just go all out. So 13, 15, 17. Whoa. Let's go back down to our 4 here. Okay, so the color changes a little bit. Okay. Wonder how far we can keep cultivating. Okay, so we can just kind of keep going until it stops. So we'll lift that up. Probably keep it down. I'm gonna line this up with that little silver dot. Let's kind of see how we do. Looks like it might actually line up pretty good. Get back in here to the center. You know, actually driving from inside allows me to make a lot finer adjustments to my track, which is good. And it's also good that the plowing doesn't have to be perfect, because when you the cultivating needs to be a little bit more perfect. Or I don't know, maybe it doesn't need to be perfect, but I think, you know, if you pick this game up, you'll kind of find out that, okay, after a while, it's going to start getting, you know, more logical, I guess, as far as how, that looks like I missed a little spot, but oh well. And actually, we could probably just drag this around. Not gonna be it. We'll do one more pass and then I think I'll call it a night. Call it an episode. Well, actually, I think maybe going over to my first point on the tracker is gonna be better. Yeah, so I'm gonna go back to my original body reference on the tracker, which is that little, you know, corner divot there. I don't know if you can kind of see where the colors on the field are changing. So that looks like it's going to be a bit better of a color reference. I can't hire a worker, you know, if I hit H, nothing happens. It's not like Farming Simulator, so, you know, you can't, at least not yet. I think down the road you will actually be able to hire a worker to come in and you know, do your fields for you, or maybe at least do certain things. I don't know if they can really do everything, but we'll find out as the series progresses. So yeah, that's really about it for today, guys. Again, you know, if you made it this far, you liked the video, please give me a thumbs up. Do not forget to do that for me. It really helps me out and helps me grow my channel. And, you know, comment, leave any kind of comments or questions you've got about the game. And don't forget to subscribe. Guys, I am BradM73. This is Professional Farmer 2014 from UIG. It's 20 bucks on Steam, probably a little bit less in euros and pounds and wherever else it's sold. So it's a pretty inexpensive game. I say go give it a try if you're into farming sims. That's it for now, guys. We'll see you in the next episode. Bye for now.